Arkansas fans got an early Christmas present. We gotta talk about it after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner shit.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young, not on step milk. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time. And today, we got to talk about Sam Pittman putting together a staff out there at Arkansas. Like, on paper, I really love Brad Davis' offensive line coach. I really love Barry Odom as the defense coordinator. But I also like Kendal Briles as the offensive coordinator. That was announced earlier today, Monday, time of this upload. Kendal Briles. New OC for the Arkansas Razorbacks up in Fayetteville, and that is crucial for Sam Pittman, who, by the way, has been nothing but a position coach up until, like, this year, and that's going back to 1993 when he was position coach at Hutchinson Community College in Kansas. Yo, my man has paid his dues, and he's also made all these great relationships throughout his many stops throughout college football. Dude grew up in El Reno, even coached in Oklahoma, coached an offensive line for John Blake, got fired. Also brought hot sauce, or recruited hot sauce, to Oklahoma. Hot sauce ended up at Oklahoma. His name is Brad Davis. Was the MVP of the offensive line 2002. Won a national title. Was on a Rose Bowl squad. Brad Davis knows what's up. Also, he from Louisiana. Means he can recruit Louisiana. And Kendal Briles from Texas means he can recruit Texas. Now, Briles, we have to mention, is Art Briles, is son. That's his daddy. And they were a part of that really sordid affair. Sexual harassment, sexual assault. Baylor. Now, it's wild, but we still have to continue to bring it up because Kendal Briles is at Houston. Kendal Briles obviously at Baylor. Kendal Briles at FAU. Kendal Briles at Florida State. And now Kendal Briles is at Arkansas. So the stigma of what went on under Art Briles' watch did not follow Kendal Briles. It certainly didn't follow Philip Montgomery up to Tulsa, and yet we still got to bring it up every single time because they were all associated. Okay? Now, that said, I've always enjoyed Art Briles' offense, and it is proprietary like you read about. I mean, look, at the University of Tulsa, word is Philip Montgomery don't even let people into his meetings. You know, like that dude just kind of siloed off. But that's also in keeping with the Briles family and how they've chosen to guard their veer-and-shoot, which is, you know, what they call the offense, but it's more like spread ISO, right? Because what they do is spread you out. And a lot of people say spread you out without actually acknowledging what that means to spread people out. Because the spread offense is a shotgun formation, but it is built to run the ball, right? And the way that Urban Meyer did it was to put dudes just inside the numbers as like slot backs and to try to run a triple option with the quarterback being their third option, right? They do much of the same thing at Baylor and in this veer and shoot in the Briles offense that Kendal Briles very well knows, but it's much more about getting one-on-one matchups for the wideouts and also taking advantage of fewer numbers in the box, right? Because you want five in the box. You would love to have five on five, but you're going to hope for six on five, right? And I'm talking about offensive linemen versus your front six, right? If you have six men in the box, I feel like you can run against that because you have a tailback, you have a quarterback, which means that you have seven to their six. Okay, if your quarterback's an option. So if anytime you get six men in the box, I think you got to run against that. And most of the time they do. They pull a lot more with their tackles in the veer and shoot. They also leverage you like you read about. And they have this really great way of basically turning their wide receivers into outstanding per catch average dudes, right? Because the knock on the offense is that you run like two routes, right? You run goes, you run post. That's about it. But you also don't really have to go hard on every snap. Matter of fact, Art Briles has told his wideouts, hey, yo, when we run the ball, don't even worry about running down the field, running people off. Don't even worry about blocking. Just take a few steps, get your wind back because you're going to be running nine routes the rest of the day. Okay, it's a knock on it, but as they say, college offenses, this one actually works, right, in a way that you just can't do it at the pros for a lot of different reasons, not the least of which is you got better athletes playing defense. But what I love most about the veer option, the ISO spread, is you line up your outside wide receivers outside the numbers and like right up against the boundary, and then you line up your inside receivers outside of the hash mark. So you are really spreading the field. You are really taking it out there, and you are forcing the DBs to declare what they are doing. So if you get a too high look against this, you're probably going to end up with six in the box, and you're going to run at it. As soon as you go single high, hey, we're taking the top off the defense, and we're going to make you try to cover one of these dudes that's going to be breaking into the middle field, one of these dudes taking off down the line. And if you have a dude with a cannon for an arm, that can absolutely just make it fly. Bryce Petty, anybody? Nick Florence, anybody? You can make this work in a real way. I think it's awesome that they're also putting this offense in, as Sam Pittman's going to be able to go get you offensive linemen, but you're also probably not going to be able to get the biggest offensive lineman that you want, at least right away. So you're going to be able to take advantage of the skinnier offensive linemen, and you're going to run hurry up. You're going to go fast, fast, fast. Every play in this offense is snapped in under 15 seconds, and the more you practice it, the faster you get. And the idea is to actually turn the game into a track meet. I'll never forget watching Art Briles' Baylor go for 600 yards rushing against North Carolina with basically just a tailback at quarterback, right? That, I mean, you just have to run with them. And if you can't run with them, it's going to be a long day. Now, I also want to add in here that with Sam Pittman pulling the strings and doing this thing called Crouton, yo, Kendal Briles going to go down there. He's going to identify talent. He's going to try to go get his quarterback. And then you have Sam Pittman to help you clean up, right? Same thing with Brad Davis going down to Louisiana. You're going to go into Oklahoma. Already went and got Miles Slusher, who's going to be playing some safety over there. This is going to be a fun look at Arkansas. I'm actually very, very high on what Sam Pittman has done so far. And I can't wait to see what the Razorbacks look like in just 2 years. Maybe even next year. I really want to see what this looks like. Because Sam Pittman's talking sidelines, letting Kendal Briles do the thing where he's doing the 5, 6, 7, 8 with the four tapes around his fingers calling out these plays. That's going to be a lot of fun to me. All right. Now, Barry Odom also has head coaching experience, was just turned around Missouri. We all know they can coach the ball. He gets that defense to hum it. All of a sudden, the SEC West might be the most fun division in all of college football next year. All right. That's it for me. Doses. First Class Heat and Air LLC is a family-owned HVAC business owned and operated in Tulsa, Oklahoma. First Class Heat and Air LLC gladly services northeastern Oklahoma. Give my man Lee a call at 918-606-1537. That's First Class Heat and Air LLC. Give Lee a call, 918-606-1537. Tell him RJ sent you.